Hi, this is Carl A. Opson at the University of Arizona. You know, the Individuals with Disabilities Education Act is a voluminous and complicated document. But special education teachers and other service professionals are still expected to be able to answer questions based on the content of IDEA. So what I want to do for you today is show you a website that makes it relatively easy to look around through the content of IDEA. And then we'll send you on a little scavenger hunt. So the place we want to start is Parent Center Hub. The Parent Center Hub took over resources that were developed by another federal dissemination center. And so if you click on resources, you will see NICHCY legacy resources in English. They also have them in Spanish. But we're going to click on the English resources. And then see the list of all the things you can find out about here. It's wonderful. But what we want to see is IDEA. And then we want to take a look at the law itself. There are summaries, if you'd like to see those. We'll talk later in the semester about guidance on IDEA. The federal government, or the Department of Education, releases guidance documents in which they interpret the content of IDEA and their intentions. And then there are training materials for IDEA, some of which I use in this course. But let's start with IDEA itself. And we're going to look at the exact words of IDEA. And you can get a copy for yourself. So you could get a PDF copy or a Word copy of IDEA. And when you need to find information, you could just search for keywords. They also have separate Part C and Part B. And Part C is early childhood, babies and toddlers. We're going to look at Part B right now. And Part B is services for school-aged children. And let's imagine a scenario in which you're a special education teacher and you have a new student come to your school, and this child just before coming in your school was placed with a foster family. And the parents can't come in to sign the document. It will be the foster parents. And you wonder to yourself, can foster parents sign the IEP document legally as parents? Well, one thing you could do would be to look under subpart A at the definitions. So we're going to look at the definition of parent. You see there's a long list of definitions, so if you ever wonder about a specific term in IDEA, subpart A is usually a place to go. Here it is, definition of a parent. And if we open that up, we see that parent means a biological or adoptive parent, and it means a foster parent unless state law, regulations, or contractual obligations with a state or local entity prohibit a foster parent from acting as a parent. So one thing you'll find as we start to look through IDEA is that it's not always a simple yes or no. In this case, a foster parent can be the parent, but the other thing you would want to do is check with your state law to make sure that there's nothing in state law that prohibits a foster parent from providing a legal signature on a document. So, what we'll do in the quiz for this course session is look at about six more scenarios. And I've given you hints for where to look within IDEA. I tell you every subpart and every section to go to. It's a nice way to learn to look around in the document. And it's a nice way to begin to gain some more insight into IDEA. This is Carly Opson, University of Arizona, and I'll see you again online.